The octopus is a rather strange-looking animal that exhibits amazingly complex behaviors. They have the most impressive nervous system in the entire invertebrate world. They have about 500 million neurons that are distributed throughout their body such that 2/3 of the neurons are actually in its legs. Now mix this in with camouflaging cells, jet propulsion, and a razor-sharp beak, and you have all the makings of a formidable predator. And then throw in the fact that the octopus is a solitary creature, and suddenly we have ourselves a real cephalopod fight. We know that almost all animals fight for food, for territory, for mates. And the octopus is no different. And knowing their fighting behavior can help us better understand these fascinating creatures and how they interact. My friend Ilya has been observing the classic fighting behavior between the California two-spotted octopus.
Most people think that it's octopi, but that's actually incorrect. The correct plurals are either octopuses or octopodes, if you want to be very Greek about it.
So how do you do your experiment?
First, I like to set up the chamber just so it's ready. So I get a jug of water. I aerate it by shaking the jug. It seems that if the water is well aerated, they're a lot more active. This gives the octopus some room to breathe. I get the first octopus.
Here, buddy. Here, pal.
Put it in. Set up my GoPro. Put the second octopus in, cover it up, and leave it alone. There's always one octopus on defense, one on offense. Usually the one that's taking up more space, that's more boastful, definitely the aggressor, most likely the winner of the fight. The loser's pretty obvious. They get pushed around, they curl up, hide in a corner. A lot of the time when there's an initial contact, if one of them is too much on the defensive side, the second one will sort of poke at it, grab at its tentacle and see, hey, do you want to fight me? Do you want to turn around? Do you want to start a wrestling match? So it'll just poke and run away. Come back, poke and run away. When the octopus come towards each other to begin the fight, they don't actually face each other. They approach sideways. The defensive octopus tries to face away from the attacker until it's the critical moment it knows there's no way to avoid a fight.
Really, the one who's waiting to the last moment is the defensive octopus.
The aggressor in a fight will quickly and sharply flash bright black on his arms when he is about to initiate a fight. Ooh.
And already,
we're seeing some action. Looks like they've spotted each other.
Right, so now he's gonna come, he's approaching, but not directly at him.
Yeah, they're like almost completely like anti-parallel.
And then right there.
Yeah, like contact, and then their arms clash together.
So we've taken the first steps in understanding fighting in the octopus. And you may be asking yourself, why does this even matter? Well, these types of curiosity-based research questions can often lead to some unexpected insights and discoveries. And we've learned a lot about ourselves from studying marine animals. Squid have taught us about how our neurons communicate. And the horseshoe crab has taught us about how our eyes work. So it's not too far of a stretch to say that some of these behaviors that we're seeing in the California two-spotted octopus are similar to ours.